6:47 to play in the game. The Americans on top 4-3. Coming into this medal round, the Soviets came in with 2 points because they beat Finland. The U.S. and Sweden came in with a point each because they tied. Finland, no points because they lost to the Soviets. You pick up 2 points for a win, one for a tie. The Americans right now on the verge of picking up a couple. As Fedosov's slap shot is blocked in front by Morrow.
It's the kind of play that you've got to make from here to the end. Is anybody, when there's a dangerous chance to fall in front of those shots?
Golikov's shot goes wide. Kasatinov keeps it in near the point. Kasatinov slap shot, knocked down in front, gloved by Craig, and a whistle with 6:26 to play in the third period. Remember, on Sunday, the other games in the medal round, it'll be the U.S. against Finland. It'll be the Soviet Union taking on Sweden.
Here's the big play by Ken Morrow, diving in front of that shot from Fedosov. The U.S. team has been getting into the kind of pattern that they want, playing the game all over the ice surface, not just in their own end. But they've got to keep continually clear their zone better.
Craig has 33 saves tonight. The two Soviet goaltenders, remember, Tretiak played the first period, Mushkin the second and third. They have only 12 saves. The Soviets have outshot the Americans by close to a 3-1 ratio, and yet it's the U.S. on top as you look at the clock. 6:26 remaining in the game. 4-3 the United States.
Here again, the U.S. team is trying to slow the pace of the game down to make sure that they're in control. Herb Brooks bringing Mark Johnson over to the bench for more instructions, the referee having to bring him back to the faceoff, but all to provide a little bit of time and a little bit of rest and a little bit of composure.
McClanahan on the faceoff against Lukov. This is Ramsey. In the center zone, the Soviets trying to get it back in. Morrow takes control of the puck now for the U.S. Kenny, number three, passing it into the Soviet end. Kasatinov back there along with Johnson. Johnson trying to clear it along the boards to Silk's side. But the Soviets are able to get it back to center ice. Golikov down to Makarov. Makarov skating into the corner, sent it out in front, but Golikov couldn't get his stick on it. Kasatinov now. Fedosov out in front. Makarov again taken out of the play. Good play by Ramsey. But the Soviets able to keep it in. And we've got a whistle as Makarov takes control.
Mike Ramsey, who's been struggling with his defensive play, particularly in front of his own net, made two very good plays in front, hooking Golikov's stick first and then clearing the puck away on the second chance.
Here's Herb Brooks, the last call the Soviets were protesting, that call for offside. But the play blown dead. The referee tonight from Finland, the two linesmen from Canada and Holland. 5:46 remaining in the game. The United States on top. 4-3. Billy Letinov shoots it in. It's deflected high. Strobel fighting for it. Back it comes to center ice. So the Soviets will have to set up again. 5.5 minutes to play. Petrov, number 16. Long slap shot. And Craig able to sweep it aside. And the puck clears the glass and goes into the seats. So Jim Craig tested time and time again tonight with 5:21 remaining in the game.
That last play, Petrov tripped a shot from outside the blue line. You see him here, but look at the U.S. team. They've got four players lined up on the blue line, and Petrov, seeing that, realized that all he could really do was take the shot.
Jim Craig. And at Boston University, he's played every minute of every game thus far in the tournament. The Americans, a 10-3 loser to the Soviets less than 2 weeks ago in Madison Square Garden. Leading right now 4-3. But remember, Canada also led the Soviets at the end of the second period, and Finland led with only 5 minutes to play in the game the other night. Ilya Letinov over to Pervukin. Pervukin shooting it into the American end. Craig leaving it there for Baker. Broughton trying to get it out, but the Soviets keeping it in as Strobel. Now Kristoff clearing it into the Soviet zone, and this will be icing here. To the faceoff in front of Jim Craig now with 4:55 remaining in the third period. The United States leading the Soviet Union 4-3.
Seen the 1980 Olympic medal round contest between the United States and the Soviet Union from Lake Placid, New York, right here on ESPN Classic.
3:53 remaining in the game. Pavlich on the faceoff in the Soviet end against Vladimir Golikov. Fedosov up to Makarov, number 24. Makarov skating into the American end. Backhander tried to get it over to Golikov. Went through the crease. as they fight for it along the near side. Now cleared over to the other side as Ramsey gets it out over the blue line. And Kasatinov is back to get it for the Soviets. Up ahead to Golikov. Golikov losing it there. Harrington in control for the U.S. Harrington, number 28. Harrington skating in. His shot. The save by Mushkin, who juggled the puck, then held on long enough for the whistle. 3:23 to play.
One of the really difficult things about playing against the Soviets and also even watching the game with the Soviets is they never allow you the chance of feeling good. When you're ahead by two goals, by one goal, you'd love to have the luxury of feeling comfortable and feeling good, and yet they can strike so fast that all of a sudden they just steal that feeling away.
Johnson on the faceoff. Johnson, McClanahan, and Silk forming the line on the ice right now for the Americans. The Soviets controlling after the faceoff, but Kharlamov loses it at center ice to McClanahan. Kharlamov. Christian gets his stick on it. They're back outside the blue line. Petrov and Silk scrapping along with Johnson and Kervukin. Now Mikhailov, the captain. Kervukin. Mikhailov leaving it to Petrov. Petrov skating it over the blue line. Kharlamov. Back of the net. The Americans take possession. Baker can't clear. Kervukin keeps it in. Now Davey Christian with a puck. 2:43 to play. McClanahan can't control. Mikhailov tried to center. That could have been costly, but it's taken away by Baker. Good play by Bill as Baker skates in with McClanahan and loses the puck, and we've got offside.
David Christian has played extremely well in this game. It's a tough thing for him. He's been a forward all year and really through his entire career, and he's been asked to go back on defense. And that's a very difficult thing to do. In earlier games, he was playing reasonably well, but he was having a hard time with his positioning. He just hasn't developed the defensive instincts. But tonight, he's in position almost all the time and playing extremely well.
Goals by Mark Johnson and Mike Ruzzioni here in the third period. The United States coming from behind to lead 4-3. 2:25, 2:24, 2:23 remaining. Starikov, number 12. Pounded by Strobel. Wells chasing it down in the corner. Mark tries to get it over to Ramsey. Ramsey comes back the other way tomorrow now. 2:09 to play in the game. Strobel up ahead to center ice. The Soviets take possession again. Get it back into the American end. But Morrow is back there for the touch and the icing call. So the faceoff and the Soviet end with 1:59 to play in the game.
Ken Morrow was properly going back slowly, knowing it was ice and trying to milk the clock as much as possible, but also remembering the other night when he did the same thing, but let it go too long. Referee blew the whistle and called the faceoff in the American zone.
Honestly, Ken, a couple of months ago, would you have believed this would be possible?
No, absolutely not. But the only thing with this U.S. team is, we've repeated it a number of times, is they're a very young and a very talented team. And when you are that kind of team, you just have no idea where it's all going to end up.
A minute 58, a minute 57 left in the game. The Soviets losing it. At center ice, it's Christian. To Baker, Bill, number 6. Shooting it into the corner. The Soviets get it back to center zone, but the Americans retain control. Baker, number 6. Baker shooting it into the Soviet end again. 1:38 remaining in the game.
Soviets are circling their forwards up near center now. Both Makarov and Golikov. They're looking for that long breakaway pass, but it makes it harder in their own zone.
And another icing call right here. 4-3, the United States. Herb Brooks, I think, said it before the tournament even started. He said to win a bronze medal in Lake Placid would be the equivalent or even more of winning the gold in Squaw Valley. The Americans obviously the better team than they had in 16, but the Soviets are so much better than they were 20 years ago.
Well, I think that the biggest difference is the fact that in 1960, most of the teams in the world were unknown one to each other, and you had no idea what to expect. In this particular case, 20 years later, all of these teams know each other pretty well, and when you can be that much of an underdog and make the kind of performance or give the kind of performance that the U.S. team has had, that's very remarkable.
All right, Pervukin over to Petrov, number 16. Petrov with a weak shot in on Craig. Easy save. Ramsey has it in the corner. A minute 15 to play. Back it comes. Can they clear the blue line? They do, and then it comes back in again, and offside is the call.
The Soviets are going to be put in a very unusual position at this moment of having to pull their goalie. The Soviet team has rarely been in the position of being down a goal this late in the game, and I wonder whether they've had much practice of getting Mushkin or Tretiak off the ice.
Remember, the Soviets have a lot of the same players on the team that came over here and beat the New York Rangers and the New York Islanders and Quebec at the end of 1979. A minute six remaining in the game. Harlamov losing it to Schilt. Now Petrov controls. Back to Harlamov. Skating in on the left side. Into the American end. 55 seconds. But Mikhailov has the puck. Mikhailov sweeping in. Out in front. Backhander goes wide. I think Krejci might have got just a piece of it. Mikhailov back out to Vilya Ledunov. 43 seconds remaining. Morrow checked into the boards. It comes back to center ice. 38, 37 seconds left in the game. Petrov with it. The Americans on top, 4-3. Long shot. Craig able to get a piece of it to sweep it away. 28 seconds. The crowd going insane. Harlamov shooting it into the American end again. Morrow is back there. Now Johnson, 19 seconds. Johnson over to Ramsey. Vilya Ledunov gets checked by Ramsey. McClanahan is there. The puck is still loose. 11 seconds. You've got 10 seconds. The countdown going on right now. Morrow up to Schilt. 5 seconds left in the game. Do you believe in miracles? Yes!
Unbelievable.
Express their emotions now. They're just jumping around. Unbelievable.
The United States hockey team, average age 22. Herb Brooks, head coach. Craig Patrick, assistant coach. Unknown, totally anonymous, a week and a half ago. Look at Herb Brooks.
No notes tonight.
Oh, oh my. Jim Craig. They're still undefeated. They've got 3 points now. They've got their fate in their own hands. They'll take on Finland Sunday. The USA champ. Just incredible. 11 o'clock Sunday morning Eastern time. The U.S. against Finland. There's O'Callaghan. So the United States has done it. Defeating the Soviet Union, the most improbable circumstance you could ever have imagined before these Olympics started. The final score, the USA 4, the Soviet Union 3.